tonight we are learning new information about the plankton that's harming hundreds of sea lions and dolphins. Fox 5's Alani Letang is live in La Jolla tonight with more on what people should know as the holiday weekend draws crowds to the coast. Alani.
Kasha, and crowds are already here in La Jolla Cove. The sea lions are already barking. And that's something that scientists want people to know, is to keep their distance, especially for those animals that might be sick. So those marine mammals, they're feeding off the shore on that dangerous plankton. They're becoming sick and they're coming near the beach. That's why you have to give them their space. And this algae is nothing new. Scientists see this every year, but each year it's becoming more and more toxic. And they said they want to make note of those impacts.
We're used to seeing these animals on the beach displaying these symptoms. What we're not used to is the numbers in which they're coming in right now. We're just seeing so many.
Scientists say people at the beach could encounter a sick marine mammal over the next few weeks. There's an algae bloom happening off the shore. The algae, or plankton, is called Pseudonychia, which scientists see every year. The plankton doesn't always become toxic and produce domoic acid. In this year's event, it has, causing hundreds of sea lions and dolphins to become sick or die.
When the animals are eating whatever fish or squid or whatever it is offshore they're eating right now in abundance, they don't see anything. They're just eating this creature, and that creature fed on other creatures that fed on other creatures that ate the plankton initially. And now you have an accumulation of this microscope, this, you know, teeny tiny molecule, this toxin in their system.
Clarissa Anderson with the Scripps Institute of Oceanography has been studying harmful algal blooms for more than 20 years. She says the bloom happens in the spring to early summer. That's when cold water from hundreds, even thousands of feet deep, pushes the Pseudonychia up.
But it does take a certain mixture of conditions to get it to be toxic. And that can be anything from the proportion of nutrients that are in the water. It could be a cross-section of that with a little bit of warming thrown in.
Scientists say the toxins are causing marine mammals to have seizures, pain. NOAA is asking people to keep their distance and wait for professional help of medication and fluids.
People on the beach are not going to be able to do anything along those lines. We have to give them plenty of fluids. And again, we don't want people pouring water on them or trying to get the animals to drink it. We actually have to do it intravenously or under the skin.
We don't want to be too anthropomorphic about it and think about just what we care about, which is these beautiful creatures that are sick.
Anderson says the Pseudonychia plankton with the toxins does contribute to a productive ecosystem, adding scientists must look through both lenses.
That's kind of the interesting bimodal thing here. You could have a really vibrant fishery, and there may be fishermen that are so stoked right now. You could also have all these sick animals. And so it's not an easy good or bad.
The good news is that this algae is not harmful for humans if they make contact with it in the water, but it is if you ingest it. The California Department of Fish and Wildlife does a weekly test of domoic acid levels, and they did not find any in the seafood that we eat here in San Diego County. Another piece of good news, and scientists say that they expect the likelihood of this algae to move away from the Southern California coast could be within 2 to 3 weeks. That is a rough estimate, and scientists will have to keep an eye on the situation. Reporting live in La Jolla Cove, I'm Alani Letang, Fox 5 News.